scripture real quick. So God wanted me to remind us about Caleb. Amen. Amen. We have to take on the posture. You know, when we have a lot of noise going around, when we have a lot of situations going around, when we have a lot of circumstances going around, a lot of happenings taking place, the Word of God says in Numbers chapter 13, and he said, and Caleb stilled the people before Moses, and he said, let us go up at once and possess it. Possess what? Possess the land. Possess our territory. To possess what belongs to us. To possess what is already rightfully ours. To remind the enemy, though giants are manifesting, though situations are happening, though things are taking place, he stilled them. He said, don't look at it with your natural eye. Let us go up at once. Let us go up in unity. Let us go up and possess what is already ours. Let us go up and take what God has already given us. Let us go up and remind the enemy that no weapon formed against us shall prosper, but every tongue that tries to rise up against us, God has already given it to us. Let us go up in one accord and let the enemy know. Let us go up in one accord and shout according to the victory that is already ours. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And then he reminded them, for we are well able to overcome. And look at your neighbor and say, we're going to go up at once. Why? Because we are well able to overcome it. So that means that he reminded them, it doesn't matter what pop up, God has already made us more than conquerors through Christ Jesus. Ain't nobody saying nothing. So he reminded them, let us go up all at once. Why? Because we're more than able. Why? Because we are conquerors through Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. Come on, you can shout right in that spot. Hallelujah. So it doesn't matter what it looks like. Amen? I said it doesn't matter what it looks like. The word tells us that we can go up together at once. He said, let's go speedily. Let's not even think about it. Don't contemplate it. Because, you know, when you think about stuff, your head, your mind games get in the way. Amen? He said, that's what he said. He stilled them first to pull them out of that place of doubt. He stilled them first to pull them out of whatever it was that was taking place in their headspace. And then he said, we're going to go up at one time. We're not even going to think about it. We're not going to look at what we're fighting. We're just going to go up all at once in one accord. We're going to rush on them. Look, rush on the city and run up on these walls. Hallelujah. You know how it is back in the day. When you were in a good fight, you just ran up on them. You didn't give them time to think about how you're going to come at them. That's what you got to do to the enemy. While you over there talking all that smack, I'm just going to run up on you real quick. Amen. And so you have to run up on the enemy real quick, because the enemy says things to get a reaction out of us. He only knows what you're doing by how you respond. So when you hear things, we pull it out of the atmosphere. We apply the blood of Jesus to it. We apply the word of God to it. We apply what God says about it to the situation. So I'm going to read it one more time. And then after I read, I just want y'all to shout in your victory place. I'm not talking about what you're looking at, what you're facing. I want you to give God a praise in advance for what has already been written. Why? Because the word of God says it is written. It is written. Jesus didn't give a he just said it's written. It's done. It's finished. Amen. And Caleb stilled the people before Moses and said, let us go up at once and possess it, for we are well able to overcome it. Amen. Not only are we going to possess it, but we're well able. That means that we have all the resources. We have all the tools. We have all the weaponry that God has given us to possess it and overcome it. Amen. Because God has built us what? Victorious. So let's welcome our praise and worship team. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And as you worship God today, worship him in that mindset that I'm going up and to praise all in one accord, all at once, because whatever is happening around me, God has made me more than able to overcome it. Amen? Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Come on, come on. Let's just give God a praise right now. Come on, just give him a hand praise right now, because he has been good, and we have gathered together in this place to give unto God what he desires from us. We have come to give him a sacrificial praise. We have come to worship him and lift him up. We have come to magnify him. We have come to honor him this morning. And so, Father, we thank you right now for all that you're doing, Lord. We thank you for who you are, God. Lord God, and we will come outside of ourselves, Father, and give unto you, Father, a total praise, Father, leaving everything, Father God, Lord, here right now, Father, in the name of Jesus. Lord God, we thank you. Lord, bless your name, Father. Come on, give him a hand praise right now. Come on, give him a hand praise right now. Father, you are worthy. Father, you are so worthy, God. And we thank you. We thank you. We thank you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He is so worthy, y'all. He's worthy. Come on. Hey.
Hallelujah.
Hey. Come on. Come on and put your hands together right now. Say no one else can receive the glory.
No one else can receive.
Come on, sing
the
glory. Say no one else can receive the praise.
No one else can receive the praise.
Say no one else can receive the glory.
No one else can receive the glory.
And no one else can receive the praise.
No one else can receive the praise.
Because he's holy. And righteous,
righteous,
omnipotent,
omnipotent,
and mighty.
Mighty.
He's Alpha,
Alpha,
Omega,
Omega,
my Redeemer,
my Redeemer,
my Savior.
There
ain't no one else can receive the glory.
No one else can receive the glory.
And no one else can receive the praise.
No one else can receive.
Come on, say,
praise.
Say, no one else can receive the glory.
No one else can.
And no one else can receive the praise.
No one else can receive.
Say it with me.
Praise.
Because he's holy,
holy,
and righteous,
righteous,
omnipotent,
omnipotent,
and mighty,
mighty.
He's Alpha,
Alpha,
Omega,
Omega,
my Redeemer,
my Redeemer,
my Savior.
Say
no one else can receive the glory.
No one else can receive the glory.
And no one else can receive the praise.
No one else can receive the praise.
Hey, no one else can receive the glory.
No one else can receive the glory.
And no one else can receive the praise.
No one else can.
Come on,
receive.
This
the
is why.
Praise.
Because he's holy.
Holy.
And righteous.
Righteous.
Omnipotent.
Omnipotent.
And mighty.
Mighty.
He's Alpha.
Alpha.
Omega.
Omega.
My Redeemer.
My Redeemer.
My Savior. I'll take nothing at all from your glory,
for
Jesus.
All you've done for me.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Say hallelujah. Say the glory. Say the glory belongs to you. Father, we thank you. You're so worthy. Come on and say hallelujah. Say hallelujah. We thank you, God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on. Hallelujah. You're worthy, Father. So worthy, God. And deserving of all the glory and the honor, Father. Lord God, and we bless you. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You are my strength. Strength like no other, strength like no other,
yes.
And it reaches to me. You are my strength, strength like no other, strength like no other, and it reaches to me. Said you are my strength.
You are my strength. Strength like no other.
Strength like no other. And it reaches
to me.
You
are my strength.
Strength like no other.
Strength like no other.
And it reaches
to me.
Come on, sing this part with me. You know what I'm saying. In the fullness of your grace, in the power of your name, you lift me up.
Hallelujah.
You lift me up.
In the fullness of your grace.
Said you lift me up.
Lift me up.
Oh, you lift me up.
Lift me up.
Said you are my strength.
You are my strength.
Strength like no
strength
other. Strength like no other. And it reaches. Strength.
You are my strength.
Strength like no other.
Strength like no other.
Strength like no other. And it reaches
to me.
Come on, come on. In the fullness of your
in
grace.
The fullness of your grace.
In the power of your name. Strength right now, is he your strength right now?
Strength like no other.
Strength like no other.
Strength like no other.
And it
reaches to me.
One more time, you are my strength.
You are my strength.
Strength like no
strength
other.
Like no
like no
other,
and it
reaches.
Hallelujah, 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 Father, hallelujah. You are my strength, Father, you are my strength. Come on, just meditate for a second. On those times that God lifted you up, over those times that God just came, he just kind of covered you right there where you were, in the midst of that place that you were in, he was right there to be your strength, to breathe strength on the inside of you. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you. Father, I thank you, Lord. You are so worthy, so worthy, so worthy, so worthy. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father.
He's given Jesus Christ, his Son. Give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks
to the Holy One.
Give thanks because he's given Jesus Christ, his Son.
Say I am rich because of what the Lord has done for us. And now let the weak say I am strong. Let the poor say I am rich because of what the Lord
Thanks.
Give thanks.
Are you thankful this morning? Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
for singing this morning. Sing with us. Give thanks, give thanks, give thanks. Give thanks with a grateful heart.
Give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks
to the Holy One.
To the Holy One. Give thanks because He's given Jesus Christ, His Son. Give thanks with a grateful heart.
Give thanks
to the Holy One.
Give thanks
because He's given Jesus Christ, His Son. And now let the weak say, I am strong. Let the poor say, I am rich, because of what the Lord has done for us. Say, I am rich because of what the Lord has done for us.
And now
let the weak say, I am strong. Let the poor say, I am rich because of what the Lord has done. Say, I am rich because of what the Lord has done for us.
Give
thanks.
All I can do is open up my mouth and say it. I'm thankful, I'm thankful, I'm thankful.
Give thanks.
Thank you for your Son, God. Hallelujah. We thank you. We thank you. We thank you. We thank you.
Come on, God.
He kept us through the pandemic. He kept us. He kept us safe. He kept us safe. Many people are gone, but we're here standing, and we're in the house of God. This morning, my heart is grateful. My heart is overflowing with gratitude this morning, God. I thank you. I thank you. I thank you. I thank you for keeping me. I thank you. I'm say thank you, Jesus. Thank you, thank you, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
With a grateful heart. Hallelujah. Come on, lift your hands. Think about your personal space with God. Amen. All the things that He's brought us through, all the things that He continued to keep us from, all the things that we haven't even experienced yet. And the song decrees that we are to give thanks with a grateful heart. Hallelujah. Because He's God. Amen. Because He's awesome. He's faithful even when we're not. Hallelujah. He's always there interceding for us. The Word of God says that He sits at the right hand of the Father, making intercession on behalf of us, that He sends His angels before us and give them charge over us. That is to protect us. That is to keep us. That is to continually lead and guide us. Amen. Even when we don't know, we need to be kept. Even when we don't know, we need to be protected. All those times when an accident should have happened, that was God, the Holy Ghost, working on behalf of us to keep us. Hallelujah. To prevent things from happening. Amen. Almost. This almost happened, but it didn't. And so for that, we ought to give God praise for it. Amen. There's something that you can give God for. There's something that you can be thankful for. Your situation may not be exactly like you needed to be in this moment, but there is something that you can be thankful for. There is something that you can be grateful for. There is something that you can give God in a moment like this. Amen. It's personal. Hallelujah. Your trials are not greater than your God. Your situations are not greater than your God. Hallelujah. I know things are a little off right now. Maybe things are just perfect, but God is still perfect in imperfect situations. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, we worship you, God. We magnify you, God. We glorify you, Holy Ghost. We give you praise. We honor you. Hallelujah. We are so undeserving of his consistent love, his constant mercy. Hallelujah. His unfailing forgiveness. Hallelujah. We fail at forgiveness sometimes, but God forgives us even when we don't deserve it. Hallelujah. We can't get over things sometimes, but God get over stuff even when he want to punish us. Amen. Hallelujah. There's something about God that says, I'm going to give them one more chance.
Yes.
Hallelujah. They should get this, but I'm going to give them this. Amen? Amen. And we've all missed the mark on that. And for that, you can give God praise. And we just going to back it up to the cross. God died, hallelujah, for mankind, that we may have an opportunity to get to know him beyond the cross experience. And for that, you may not understand it, but we can give him praise for that. Amen. We can be thankful and grateful that he died for sinful people, not even knowing whether or not we're going to respond the way that we should respond to him. Amen? Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Jesus.
David is the greatest expression to me of gratitude, of thankfulness. He wrote the psalm. He said, I will bless the Lord at all times. And continually, his praises shall be in my mouth. Now, but you got to know the history. You got to know the history. The history is David had just come. He wrote that psalm after he had come up, after he had come out of a time where he almost died. After all his friends had turned his back. After Absalom tried to have him destroyed. Then he wrote the psalm, I will bless the Lord at all times. And that means in the midst of my trials, in the midst of my circumstances, in the midst of my frustration, in the midst of my pain, in the midst of everything that I'm going through. He wrote that psalm after his greatest I almost died. David said, I will bless the Lord at all times. In other words, on my deathbed, I'm going to still find a reason to give God some glory. Hallelujah. I will bless the Lord at all. And continually, his praises shall be in my mouth. A man of God told me, and I live my life this way. He told me, he said, the best barometer of your relationship with Jesus is your gratitude. If you want to know where a person's relationship is with Christ, listen to those. You want those that pray for you that's always thanking God. You know what they're going through. You know they fight some stuff, but they are always thanking God. You can catch them every now and then in a bad mood, but when it's time to give God some praise, when it's time to give God some glory, hallelujah, their hands go up, their praises go up, hallelujah. I don't want that person. Oh, I don't want to. Don't pray for me if I'll never see you worship, if I'll never see you giving God glory. You find that person, you know they got some suffering going on, but they find them a corner. You find them in a corner. You find them in a corner. You find them in a corner. Find them in a corner all by themselves sometimes. Worship here. Worship here. You find them just crying, just all of a sudden. They ain't sad. They're giving God glory because their situation could be worse. It could be worse. Yeah, it could be worse. Hey, you almost, my wife said, you almost died, but you didn't. Yeah. Find a reason. Find a reason. Find a reason. I don't care where you are. I don't care what you're going through. Find a reason to give God some glory. Yeah, find a reason to worship him. Find a reason. Find a reason. Find a reason. Right now where you are, find a reason. Find a reason. I don't care who made you mad. I don't care who frustrated you. Find a reason to give God some glory. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for keeping me. Thank you, Lord, for holding me. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Everybody can fix their mouth to say thank you. Come on. All over this house. Come on. Say thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. We bless your name. We bless your name, Jesus, my God. We bless your name, Jesus. We bless your name, Jesus. I'm telling you. I'm telling you. I'm telling you. I don't care where you go, what you're going through, where you are. If you just let your mouth fix on Jesus. If you just fix your mind on Jesus. If you just start thinking about it. That's why he said, that's why he says in the midst of my trials, when I think on Jesus, then my soul begin to cry out. My flesh don't want to. Oh, my flesh is in pain right now. My flesh don't even want to. But my soul takes over. The thing that he saved my flesh is dying from the day that it was born. But Jesus saved my soul. And so when my flesh don't want to give him glory, my soul says, oh, my soul begins to cry out, hallelujah, yeah, yeah, hallelujah, hallelujah. My soul won't let my flesh, hallelujah. I don't care what you're going through, what you're facing right now. Let your soul just worship. Your soul will begin to take over your soul, because your soul knows better than anything else what God has been to you. Your soul knows better than anything else how awesome he's been. How glorious he is. How magnificent he is. He's glorious. He's wonderful. He's glorious. He's wonderful. He's wonderful. He's glorious. He's full of majesty. He's full of dominion. He's full of power. He's awesome. He's awesome. He's awesome. He's awesome. He's awesome. He's awesome. I bet you one thing. Y'all stay right there and look like zombies if you want to, but I'm going to preach myself happy. I know the weight that I carry. I know the things that I got to go. Y'all don't even know what's going on right now. I know what I go through. Hallelujah. And he keeps me. Hallelujah. I don't deserve for God to keep me, keep healing me over and over again. Keep my legs moving over and over again. Keep my mind sound over and over again. Hallelujah. So we give thanks this morning, Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Come on, somebody say thank you. Come on, someone say thank you with me. Say thank you, Jesus. Come on. Come on, say thank you with me. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, that in spite of me, thank you, Lord, you still love me. Thank you, Lord, you hold me. Thank you, Lord, you keep me, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, in spite of me. Thank you, Lord, y'all perfect. I'm broken. Y'all perfect. I'm perfectly broken. That's all. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for not holding it against me. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for not treating me like I thank you, like I treat you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Y'all, good. Get tired if you want to. I gotta stay here all night. I need this for my own self. I need this for myself. Hallelujah, Jesus. I don't need nobody to preach me happy. I preach myself happy. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, Father. In the midst of my trials, I say thank you, Lord. In the midst of my suffering, I say thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. To whom much is given? To whom much is given, I just hear that in my spirit. To whom much is giving, much is required. Hallelujah. Some of us go through much, but God has much for you. To whom much is given, much is required. To whom much is given, hallelujah. To whom much is given, hallelujah. To whom much is given, much is required. To whom much is given, Ah, Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father, that there was a few people in this house that is thawed out. The rest of the church are the frozen chosen. But there's a few of us that are thawed out. Come on, anybody here that thawed out? Hallelujah! Anybody here that thawed out? And worship God, not because somebody asking you to do it, but because you just know it's right. Yeah. Hallelujah. I get people, they got people sometimes, they just, I don't feel like it. I don't sense that. You got to sense something to worship God? I always sense a praise. I remember Apostle Turner told me once, he said, it is all praise and worship is always in order. You ain't never out of order to give God some glory. You can stand up and shout in the middle of my sermon. Hallelujah. Your heart, if your spirit just takes off by itself, it's always in order. Hallelujah. You ain't never out of order to worship, give God some glory. You ain't never, that's always in order. Hallelujah. It's always in order. Worship can't get, worship and praise can't follow no clock. Hallelujah. Can't follow no schedule. Can't follow no itinerary. Hallelujah. 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 Because every time you try to stop thinking, you remember just that one more thing. Every time I try to stop, yes, I remember that one more thing. Hallelujah. That I had almost forgotten about.
Yes, come on.
But he did that too.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Is it just me? If you live long enough, if it's just you, if it's just me, it's fine. But you live just a little bit longer, you remember that one more thing.
Yes. Come on now.
That he did, that he didn't have to.
Hallelujah.
And one more thing, he did one more thing for me that he didn't have to do. Hallelujah. Every time I try to stop. One more thing that he did. I don't know about y'all, but I deal with death every day. Hallelujah. But I remember that one more thing. That one more day that he gave me. Hallelujah. That one more time I felt like, Tim, I felt like throwing in the towel. But he gave me one more day of strength. He said, son, I know you don't feel like walking no more, but get up. I know you don't feel like carrying your cross anymore. Pick it up. All right. I know we have a program we have to get to, but. Y'all think I be doing this for y'all? No, you don't know. You don't know this about me. Hallelujah. To remember that one more thing. To remember that one more thing. He's a God. His mercy endures forever. His mercy. His grace is sufficient for me. Trust you, because without your love for me, I wouldn't even know how to trust you. That as was your grace that taught me even to trust you. I don't even trust you on my own. I don't even trust you on my own. It is by his grace. And I can even trust you, Father. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Come on, baby. Because I'll be here all day. It's personal to me. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I know what I wake up fighting every day. Y'all don't know because I don't tell you. I know what I deal with every day, Pastor Parker. But he gives me his grace. And it's sufficient for me. It's enough. His grace is enough. It is. I don't care. I don't care what you're going through. His grace is enough. He has enough grace for your situation. I promise you that. Yeah, he has enough grace. There's enough grace. There's enough grace there. He don't run out. There's enough grace for your trial. There's enough grace for your situation. There's enough grace for your pain. There is enough. Yeah, he's enough. He's enough. He's our exceeding great reward. Reward exceeds greatness. It's beyond greatness. Come on. Come on. I know we got to move on, but we got time for this. I don't know. There's a praise in the atmosphere. There's a praise in the atmosphere. There's a praise in the atmosphere. There just is. Hallelujah. Yeah. So, Father, we leave it with thank you. Yeah. Baby, I feel better now. I know you worry about me sometimes, but you know your man is good. I'm good. Yeah. I feel better now. It's something about praise worship. It's something about the fullness of joy that abides in the presence of the Lord. Something about his presence. It just makes everything better. The old folks used to say, come on, baby. The old folks used to say, ain't he all right? You remember that, Pastor Parker? Old folks would say, ain't he all right? Yeah, Aaron, I know you remember that. Ain't he all right? Yeah, there was, and the congregation would say, what they used to say? He's all right. Ain't he all right? Come on, I'll see. Ain't he all right?
He's all right.
Yeah, he's all right. Yeah, he's all right. He's all right. Yeah, he's all right. Yeah, I heard somebody say, all right, all right. Yeah, that's what they used to say, all right, all right. Yeah, all right, all right. He all right. He's all right, all right. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He's all right with me. Yeah, he's all right with me. He's all right. Yeah, my God is all right. My Father is awesome. My daddy bigger than your daddy. Bet you my daddy can whoop your daddy. Unless we got the same daddy. Hallelujah. Come on, baby. I mean, for real. I love y'all. Thank you for affording me this time. I needed this for me this morning. Now, I was advantaged. I have a little bit of advantage. I could do this. You ain't got to like it, but I could do it. I needed this. I needed it. Hallelujah. Amen. Y'all all right this morning? Amen. Come on, clap those hands one more time. We move on and let our babies do what they do.
Hallelujah. Come on, shout one more time. Hallelujah. Come on, shout like God. That like you really, really mean it. It's agreement in the atmosphere. Amen. We're just agreeing with all that God continues to do. Hallelujah. All right. So we're going to move into the rest of the service. Amen. God is so faithful. You know, the enemy always does his job, and God always does his job. Amen. So it doesn't matter what the enemy brings to us, you have to know that you are more than a conqueror through Christ Jesus, because he strengthens you. And even when you feel like you're weak, God say in your weakness he makes us strong. And what that means, that he chooses to share his strength with us. And so when God is pushing us, then we're already victorious, amen, because he's guiding us as he's pushing us. So it's not, we only feel faint when we begin to operate in our own capacity. But when you trade your capacity for God capacity, then it doesn't even feel the same, amen. And that's where he's trying to get us to, where we stop operating within our own capacity, but then we get to truly live, move, and have our beings where? In Christ Jesus, amen. So we can shout to God one more time. And we're just agreeing, amen? All right, so we have a super, super excited service today only because we truly believe in pushing our youth, amen? They just not a body in the congregation, amen? But this is how they're just not a body in the congregation, amen? They're just not a body in the congregation, amen? Amen. This is how we train them, and the best way to train them to embrace their mandates and their callings and their expressions through Christ is on the job, what? Training. Get it done. Amen. So you give them the platform and you let them do them by the Holy Ghost. Now it may be trial and error. That's okay, because we realize we're training them to do all things as unto the Lord. They realize they're not performing, but it's training ground, right? So when you're on training ground, sometimes you don't get it right. So they grow into who God has called them to be. So for that reason, we're super excited, because Joel talks about our generation, that our sons and our daughters will what? They will have dreams and visions, and they'll prophesy, they'll do all those things. But if we don't give them the liberty to do that, they'll never discover the unique person that they are in Christ. Amen? All right, so on that note, we're going to turn it over to our youth leaders. So we need an extra mic. Amen. So look at them. They ready. They don't even need no prep. They just rolling in it. That's how you do it. We don't need no introduction. They ready to run over the devil. Amen.
Thank you, Lady T. Good morning, everybody. Thank you. Welcome to His Dwelling Place International. Are y'all ready for it? I'm a little nervous, but we'll get through it. Welcome to Generation Extreme Young Ministry. Today's theme is bigger dream. Today's theme is bigger dreams, Jeremiah chapter 29, verse 11. I'm your MC. My name is Tanaya, and let's get to it. So, first up, we have prayer by Tim Jr. Come on, man. You got this? Okay.
I am the third, not junior. May you please bow your heads while I lead us in prayer. Father God, I pray that on this night, everybody that worships you on this day, Father God, that the people that are watching get to see you move through them. And that on this day, people are feeling great in your name. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
That was powerful. When he said, that was great. That was really good. Good job. Okay, we're going to move on to CJ with a scripture. You ready? All right.
How y'all doing? I have everything typed down. I'm coming from Hebrews 12 and 1. Therefore, since we are surrounded by such a great cloud of witnesses, let us throw off everything that hinders us and the sin that easily entangles. And let us run with perseverance the race marked out for us. And I think as Christians, we have it confused that we need to that we think we need to prove our love to God, and so we try to carry our burden on our own. When Psalms 55:22 says, "Cast your burden on the Lord, and He will sustain you. He will never be, He will never let righteousness be shaken." And God never lets anything come upon us that is more than we can bear. But that doesn't mean overcoming temptation won't be hard. Overcoming the attacks of the enemy is going to be difficult, but that's why the Bible says, "He that endureth to the end will be saved." If we keep our eyes on the Lord, He will make your path straight, Proverbs 3:6. But when we cast our cares onto the Lord, we cannot become lazy in the spirit, because that's when the devil sees our guard is down and he attacks. 1 Peter 5:8, "Be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, walks around like a roaring lion, seeking whom he can devour."
Don't you dare get lazy on the Lord. Don't you dare. Okay, so now we have a testimony with Bizamaya. I'm sorry. Come on, Z. Let's go.
How doing? That's good. So real quick, I just wanted to give a testimony. So, you know, to God be the glory, I finished the 10th grade with all A's and B's.
Yeah!
Thank you. For me, this was a bit difficult because COVID had a really big effect on learning. You know, although me in particular, I did in-school learning, it was still on a computer. So we were in a class, but they told us do the assignments on the computer, and if you need help, we'll help you. But it was very difficult because, you know, I don't learn over a computer. I like when someone teaches me. So, you know, yeah. So it was very, you know, hard to get what I needed. Also, tests were on computers. And I don't know how you guys take tests, but I take tests by writing and underlining and highlighting and annotating. You know, it helps me, you know the right answer. But when it's on a computer, you can't do that. So every time I had a test, I always like, you know, Lord, let me pass, at least with a 70, just let me pass. But, you know, checking my grades yesterday, I found out most of my finals, I got 90s or above. So, yeah, thank you. So, you know, that was something that was just really amazing to me. And also, I do AP classes, so an 89 in an AP class would be a 90-something in a regular class, which academically is a big advantage for me. So I say all this to say that if there's ever a time in your life with your walk with God, or if you're in that time right now where everything was going so good, but all of a sudden something goes wrong, don't be pessimistic and don't think like, oh, the world has turned on me. Why is this happening to me? You know, don't think like that. Except, you know, ask God and pray for God. And pray, you know, that you have the strength to move on. Because remember that just because your situation changed, God's plans for you didn't. So you gotta keep moving, and yeah, that's what I have. But yeah, that's all I had for you guys.
When she said all A, I was like, dang, I got B's up in here. So we got that with Zamaya. Now we have Robin with Words of Expression. Come on up, Robin.
I encourage everyone here to hold on to the prayer of God. Being told not yet is not a no, and being delayed isn't being denied. That is why we never give up. Through our body are dying, our spirit are being renewed every day. For our passing, Trouble are small and won't last very long. Yet they produce for us a glory that vastly outweighs them and will last forever. So we don't look at the troubles, we can see now. Rather, we fix our glares on things that cannot be seen. For the things we see will soon be gone, but the things we cannot see will last forever. 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 16 through 18.
Everything God has planned for you, you won't always see it, but he will do it in the end. That is so true. So now we have a song by Brother Aaron, some spontaneous worship. You ready?
Testing 1, 2, okay, amen. Glad to be in service one more time. Just like you said, being thankful. Thank God, waking up in the morning. I'm be running. I don't be knowing what I'm going to sing. But I hope whatever I sing, I hope it bless y'all today. I hope God use me in a mighty way. But I want to encourage the youth. When I was in college a couple of years ago, I got into some trouble. I was working at a job at Walmart, and I was working there. I had the dude, thought it was my friend, to drop me off at work. I was working at Walmart full time. So what he told me to go in there, get a solid $100 bill and a $40 gift card. So I didn't pay attention to what he said. I was like, all right, whatever. We homies. That's what I thought. So I went in there and did that. Then after I gave the lady the money, the counterfeit money, it was counterfeit money. When she marked it, it marked black. So I'm like, what in the world going on? So the dude came inside Walmart, and I'm mad. I'm furious. So I'm like, man, did you know this money was fake? He said, nah. So he ran down to Walmart and left me behind by myself. So the cops end up coming in, and they end up asking me all kinds of questions. I said, well, I know God is going to get me out of this situation regardless of what y'all talking about. That's how much faith I had. And they was laughing. I'm about to shout on myself. They was laughing at me. They could never understand, you know, what I was talking about. So they took me to they handcuffed me and took me to the police station, asked me all kind of questions. So any kind of type of black man, they ready to take to jail. Hello, somebody. So they had a whole corner of white cops. I'm not trying to be racist, but white cops. And they was like, each 20 was 10 years in jail. So I had 8. Woo! I had 8. I couldn't. I'm thankful. Glory. Woo, glory. Oh, glory. But I'm thankful. But they said, well, I don't know how God is going to get you out of this, but he can't. But I'm not trying to make the story too long. So the FBI ended up coming to my mama's house. And my mama said, oh, Lord, get here. The FBI is here. I ain't never seen an FBI day in my life. Hello, somebody. And they going upstairs. I asked me all kind of questions. And they were saying, well, can we look for a machinery, whatever the machine, shoot out money or something. So they asked me, can they look upstairs in my room? They tore up my room trying to find a machine that I never had because I didn't know what was going on. So after I went to the altar every Sunday. Ooh, thank you, Jesus. I went to the altar every Sunday and started praying. And my mama started pleading the blood of Jesus. So she called. One day she called the head chief that was over it. And she said, what I need to do to get my son, I'm going to get him a lawyer. What I need to do? She said, you know what? We couldn't find nothing. Glory to God. We couldn't find nothing, but your son can go back because they kicked me out of school. Your son can go back to school, and he's not suspended no more. So I thank God for what he's done. What I'm trying to say, young youth, believe and trust in God that he'll make a way. Regardless of your situation, you got to trust him. I'm done. I'm finna get this song, and I'm done. I have to encourage some of you. Come up here, youth. Y'all sit in the front row. I remember back in the day, We was in the front row. Come on up here. We finna jam today. Clinton, get off that thing back there and get on these drums. Thank you, brother. You do a good job turning up the volume, but I don't need no volume. I need you over here. Yeah! Come on, you! How many of y'all God's got a blessing with your name on it? Woo! Glory! Y'all understand what I've been through, and I just thank God. Y'all ready? Y'all know this song? Do all y'all know this song? God's got a blessing? Well, we're gonna try to sing it together, all right? Clap your hands, you. What you're going through, you're gonna make it. Watch God send you through. Hold your head up, put a smile on your face. It's another test, it don't last always. So get ready,
ready
for your blessing. Hurting deep down inside. Let me encourage you, it's gonna be alright. Troubles and trials don't keep you strong. Just keep on believing, keep on holding on. So get ready for your blessing. Get ready for your miracle. Come on, you, stand up, hey, say God's got a blessing, yeah, 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 say God's got a blessing, yeah, don't be shy, it's okay, say God's got a blessing, what's your name on it, 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 what's your name on it. With your name on it. Watch this. Late in the midnight hour, God's gonna turn around. He's gonna wake your favor. Yeah, yeah. Late in the midnight hour, God's gonna turn around. He's gonna wake your favor. Everybody, stay late, late in. Yeah. He's gonna.
Yeah.
Come on, you.
I could be, I can dream. A gymnast, I could be, I could dream. A teacher, I could be, I could dream. A fashion designer, I could be, I could dream. A scientist, I could be, I could dream.
Big, no dream is too small. No dream is so big, no dream is too small.
Just be sure you include God in them all. Started talking too early. A dream. So now we have a skit. Oh, I'm in this one. I'm in this one. Okay. Like, what do I do? You know, I don't have any plans or any dreams. You didn't plan anything for me. You know what? The Bible isn't for me. I think that's the problem, you know, because biomedical engineering means nothing. You know, I have no money. I can't go to college. Like, what do I do? I do nothing. That's the problem, you know, God.
Samara, you are more than a conqueror.
I know I'm a conqueror, but I don't think I'm more than that. That's the problem. But God, you don't do anything for me. It's just getting so irritating. Like, I want to go to college, but I don't have the money. I just don't know what you want. Am I even supposed to go for biomedical engineering? Maybe you want me to be a florist. Maybe that's it. No, I hate flowers. I'm allergic to them.
Greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world.
Okay, but I'm not in the world. I'm in church. That's the thing. I don't know what to do. And God, you're not helping me at all. I don't know what's the problem. God, I really need you right now. You know what? You're not listening to me. My prayers don't even matter, do they? No, they don't. That's the thing. What do I do? I want to go to college, but like I said, I don't have the money. And I don't even know what I would
do. Zamaya. No weapon formed against you shall prosper, and no tongue, and no tongue that rises against you shall be condemned.
You say that, but actually my car got stolen last week, and not only that, but my house caught on fire, and my dog died, so no weapon formed against me, really? Yeah, no, God, I don't think you're really helping me right now. This is not going good. Like, this is just a waste of time, it really is, because, I want to believe you, but I just can't. Like, I don't know what to do anymore, God, and I don't know what I need to do. Like, do I need to pray? Because that doesn't seem to be helping at all. Or do I continue with college? Or, like, what do I do? Do I need to die and go to heaven?
Samaya, if God gave you the vision, he will provide provision.
Oh, that's the problem, God. You didn't give me a vision, so how are you going to provide provision? You know, you're not, because, you know, I don't have a vision. I don't know what I'm going to do. I don't know if biomedical engineering is right. I don't have a vision. You know, that's the thing. You provide provision. You have to provide provision to people that you have visions.
God's plans for your life are bigger than you could ever imagine. So stop worrying and give all your cares to the God and cast your burdens on the Lord, all right?
You're right. They were, God, you were right this whole time. You do have bigger dreams for me. Thank you.
The way she was just going back and forth with herself kind of stressed me out. But she was, I don't know. I didn't know who was right. And then she turned me down with my stuff, and I'm like, okay. Now we have Burgundy, Sister Burgundy, with a dance. Give her a round of applause as she comes up.
love when Sister Brittany dances. Because every time, like, every way she moves is, like, really powerful and moves me, man. Okay. We have a special ministry by your brother, my brother, Tyro Depik. Leave him some noise.
Thank you so much. Y'all give it up for the youth. I'm blessed to be here on today. This place is a safe place for both me and my wife, so we want to thank you all so much for inviting us to come here. Thank you so much, Apostle Johnson, Apostle First Lady Johnson as well. Thank you. Thank you for trusting us to come and share our gift and supporting us and allowing us to express what God has for the church. To see the youth, once again, like I say all the time, to be able to see the youth use their gifts unto the Lord, it truly is a blessing. It's something that, you know, I didn't see too much growing up as a child. And so I just really want to encourage the youth to continue to allow God to use you, to continue to be faithful, to continue to stand bold in who God is on the inside of you. Whenever you are trusting God and you allow him to use you through your gift, you're reinforcing who God is on the inside of you. And it truly takes you a long, long way. So I truly encourage you guys to continue to allow God to use you. Anytime that me and my wife, we are currently going through another transition, and it seems as if every time we go through a major transition, God sends us here. It seems like God sends us here, and I believe he sends us here because the name of this house is Dwelling Place, meaning that it is a safe place. So we haven't been to church since the pandemic. It's been about a year. So for this place to be the first place we come to after the pandemic or during the pandemic, it is truly a blessing. So we truly appreciate you guys. So I'm going to do two songs. One song is called The Plan. This song was inspired and that was given to me by the Holy Spirit last year in 2020 from Jeremiah 29 and 11. We all went through the pandemic and in some sense still going through the pandemic right now. And the Holy Spirit spoke to me. He was just speaking to me through the word, and he was saying that the plans that I have for you are of good and not of evil, plans to give you a hope and a future. And we hear that all of the time, but in context, God spoke. He sent his prophet Jeremiah to speak to his people because they were exiled out of their homeland and were taken over by a foreign king, by the Babylonian Empire. And God sent his prophet Jeremiah to say that even though you may have been exiled, even though you may have been isolated, I still have a plan for your life. So isn't it amazing that even in the midst of a pandemic, or even in the midst of being exiled, in the midst of being in isolation, pandemic, God still sends a word in the middle of that and said, I still have a plan for you. Plans of good and not of evil. Plans to give you a hope and a future. So I just really want you guys to take in that word. And that's the first song. Let's go. You got the plan, you got the plan, and you're gonna see it through to the end. So I put it all in your hands, so I put my trust in no man. You got the plan, you got the plan, and you're gonna see it through to the end. So I put it all in your hands, cause I put my trust in no man, yeah. You got the plan, you got the plan. Y'all know the Lord has a plan for your life, right? You got the plan, Lord. Hey, cause you got the plan, you got the plan, and you're gonna see it through to the end. So I put it all in your hands, cause I put my trust in no man. You got the plan, you got the plan, and you're gonna see it through to the end. So I put it all in your hands, cause I put my trust in no man, Lord. You got the plan, you got the plan, you got the plan, I know. You got the plan, you got the plan for sure. You got the plan, you got the plan, you're gonna see it through to the end. So I put it all in your hands, hey, my trust in your man. Hey, I
I've seen you work before. I've seen you all so close. Feeling your presence that touch my soul. Just to let me know, there is nothing more amazing. Your love is a gift, I'd like to embrace it. Rather than shame, I'd rather be shameless. Carry a debt instead of your payment, Lord. Blinded approaches said there is no other way. Didn't see it coming, but somehow you made a way. Yeah. Fear dissipated, you made it all fade away. Oh, life is dead, your life is dead. Your life has given me courage to say it. Lord, you're my foundation, the rock that I build on. Firm enough to stand on, this is my position. You're more than a friend, and you've always been solid. What more can I say? You got me when I pray. Cause you got the plan, and you're gonna see it through to the end. So I put it out in your hands. Cause I put my trust in no man. You got the plan, you got the plan, and you're gonna see it through to the end. So I put it out in your hands. So I put my trust in no man, Lord. You got the plan, you got the plan, you got the plan, I know. You got the plan, you got the plan for sure. You got the plan, and you're gonna see it through to the end. So I put it all in your hands.
Hey,
put my trust in no man.
Hey.
I had to get out of my own way so that you could have your own way. That's woman, I'm falling for your way. Hey, had to consider that my plan, even the plans of another man, wasn't sufficient for your plan. Hey, when I thought that I seen it all, was it compared to what you had all along? Now I'm singing a brand new song. So I dance, and I sing, and I play, and I praise, and I worship. And when I don't understand, doesn't mean that my life is not in your hands. Yeah. You've worked it out in advance for my advance. It's been your plan, y'all. Cause you got the plan, and you're gonna see it through to the end. Hey, put it all in your hands. Cause I put my trust in no man. You got the plan, and you're gonna see it through to the end. So I put it all in your hands. Put my trust in no man.
In the midst of your isolation,
you got the plan.
In the midst of your struggle,
you got the plan.
In the midst of your fears,
you got the plan. You got
the plan. In the midst of uncertainty,
you got the plan.
He has a plan for your life.
You're gonna see it through to the end.
It doesn't matter where you are right now.
Put it all in your hands.
He has the plan.
Put my trust in no man.
Hey. You got the plan, and you're gonna see it through to the end. So I put it all in your hands, cause I put my trust in no man. You got the plan, and you're gonna see it through to the end. So I put it all in your hands, cause I put my trust in your man, yeah. Cause you got the plan, you got the plan, you got the plan, I know. You got the plan, you got the plan for sure. Cause you got the plan, you got the plan, and you're gonna see it through to the end. So I put it all in your hands, cause I put my trust in no man, yeah. That's the plan.
So the last time I came here was in 2019, and at the time I was in the midst of writing and recording the album Mixed with Faith Recipe 2. And I don't know if you guys remember, last time I came I did a song called Done. Done. It's already done. It's already done. No need to respond. Y'all remember that song? So God gave me a word back in 2017 in the book of Nehemiah. Nehemiah was a cupbearer to a foreign king, and the children of Israel were allowed to go back to their homeland, and they were in the process of rebuilding. Well, at the time, the walls had not been rebuilt. The walls was torn down. And so Nehemiah got a word from his friends, and he was like, man, I got to do something about this. Lord, I ask that you would give me a plan. I ask that you would give me a strategy. Grant me with favor with the king so that I could go back to my home country and rebuild the walls. And God spoke to me through that word, and he gave me a word, and he said, what I want you to do with my people is to build, encourage, and motivate their faith, because the walls of their faith have been torn down. And so last year, August of 2020, God gave me a word, and he brought me back to this word, but instead he brought it back through Haggai. Haggai, the people were at the time were supposed to be rebuilding the temple of the Lord. But during the process, there were a lot of people that was trying to stop them from rebuilding the temple. And so in that time, they got so discouraged that they completely lost their desire to rebuild the kingdom of God, to rebuild the temple of God. And so God came to Haggai. He said, tell my people, I hear them saying that now is not the time to build my house. I see you building your own houses. I see you planting your own vineyards, but you have completely neglected building my house. And so God sent Haggai, and Haggai went and he spoke to the people. And the word says that when God spoke to the people and said, go up to the mountains, go get the timber, go get the lumber, go get the supplies you need to rebuild my temple. And the Bible says that when God spoke that word, he gave them enthusiasm. See, God was upset because the people lost their desire to build his temple. There's something, there's supposed to be a sense of excitement and enthusiasm when you're building whatever God is calling you to build. And what happened during the process of building, they got discouraged. And they stopped, and their desire for building stopped. And God was more so upset at the desire. So God said, tell my people, I know you're going through a pandemic right now. I know everything has been put to a halt right now, but now is not the time. But now is not the time for you to not build the house. Now is the time to go back and rebuild my house. And he said, when you go rebuild my house, I promise you, I will open up the windows of heaven. I will shake the heavens. I will shake the earth. And so this song was birthed out of it. And this song is called Finish. And this song is just a representation to go back, whatever it is that God told you to do. Even if it was before the pandemic, you know what it is God told you to do. Go fill out that application. Go back to school and get your master's. Build that ministry. Build that business. Whatever it is that God told you to do, he said, now is the time to go back and do it. He said, finish. Finish what you have started. I know you've gotten discouraged. I know you've gotten distracted. I know that all kind of spiritual warfare has come upon you to stop you from building what I told you to build. I know the pandemic happened, but I'm telling you right now, now is the time to build my house. So that's for everybody in here. So I have something. I brought this. This is a checkered flag. And this checkered flag, at the end of Haggai, God said to Zerubbabel, who was the priest at the time who was responsible for building the kingdom and building the temple, he said that when you go back to building my temple, I'm gonna wear you like a signet ring to my finger. And that signet ring represents power. It represents authority. And God said, I'm gonna give you power and I'm gonna give you authority to build what I told you to build. And so that signet ring was just a sign. It was a symbol to show that God was with his people. So God told me to bring this because you gotta see it. And he said, this is gonna be your sign to finish what I told you to start. So I'm just gonna walk like this real quick. I'm gonna let you take it in. Let the Holy Spirit speak to you. Let him give you a strategy. Let him give you your plan. Let him build back up your faith. You see this sign right here. This sign means finish. And this sign means that I am with you. I am with you. So I'm going to ask the youth, where the youth at? I know y'all scattered out. Let me get y'all back up here. So I need a volunteer. And you can pass this around while I'm doing the song Finish. Each of you guys could take a turn and wave that flag, because that flag is a symbol for you to finish what God told you to start. So let's get it.
What you mean, what you mean?
Hey, 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 what you mean? Y'all ready to finish this race?
I got you.
Hey, hey, hey.
Finish, finish, watch me. Finish, I'm on finish, I'm not finished. Then I'm finished, then I'm finished. Make it to the finish, make it to the finish. Finish, finish, watch me finish. I'm a finish, I'm not finished. Then I'm finished, then I'm finished. Make it to the finish, make it to the finish.
that goal, it's time to go. I don't have no time to waste, Lord knows, nor do I have time to play. I'm getting close, gated up with momentum, I'm on the road. Hey, I see the end from the beginning. Hey, that means it's already finished. Hey, God gave me the permission. Hey, so I'm already winning, no hesitation. I know that it's mine. Victory's given, I had to get it inside. Something that came to mind, it made me alive. I don't need to be perfect, no, cause I'm crossing the line. Hey, the race is not given to the strong nor the swift. Saw an opportunity, I had to take a risk. Born for this moment, this is what I waited for. If you only knew what I had to endure. Finish, finish, watch me finish. I'm on finish, I'm not finished. When I'm finished, then I'm finished. Make it to the finish, make it to the finish. Finish, finish, watch me finish. I'm a finish, I'm not finished. When I'm finished, then I'm finished. Make it to the finish, make it to the finish. I have to focus, I need the focus. I'm so focused, my only focus is going in full motion. There's no more room, just so you notice. It means that whatever door's open, and now I'm closing. Hey, yeah, I know my time is coming. When it comes, I'm taking off and running. Gonna turn nothing into something. Now I know what I'm becoming. It was needed to suffer the pain. I came through the fire and I was never the same. Had nothing to lose and yet had so much to gain. They counted me out and yet still I remain. Cause the race is not given to the strong nor the swift. Saw an opportunity, I had to take a risk. Born for this moment, this is what I waited for. If you only knew what I had to endure. Finish, finish, watch me finish. I'm a finish, I'm not finished. When I'm finished, then I'm finished. Make it to the finish, make it to the finish. Finish, finish, watch me finish. When I'm finished, then I'm finished.
That's what you tell the devil. That's what you tell the devil.
Just in case you got it.
Just in case you got it. I made it.
Just in case you got it. Hey, I made it. Hey, I know you didn't see it coming, but I made it.
How many of y'all know you made it?
No, you didn't see
it. We made it through 2020. This is your word, finish. Your word, finish. Your word, finish.
Finish, 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 finish. The race is not given to the strong nor the swift. Saw an opportunity, I had to take a risk. Born for this moment, this is what I waited for. If you only knew what I had to endure. Finish, finish, watch me finish. I'm a finish, I'm not finished. When I'm finished, then I'm finished. Make it to the finish, made it to the finish. Finish, finish, watch me finish. I'm
you gotta see yourself making it to the finish line.
When I'm finished,
you might be stumbling. You might be broken. You might be tired. You might have to take some steps back. You might even fall. You might get out your lane. Get back in your lane. Pick yourself back up. It doesn't matter the pace. The race is not given to the strong nor the swift. But to the one who endures to the end.
I'm finished, then I'm finished.
Run your own race.
Made it to the finish.
You're not in competition with nobody. God has given you your own calling.
When I'm
your own
finished,
mandate.
Then I'm finished. Make it to
you
finish.
Have your own
way.
Book of Proverbs, he said. He said, let your eyes look straight. And keep your eyes looking straight. Don't look to the left. Don't look to the right. Don't look behind you. Keep going. And keep moving. And finish.
No, you didn't see it coming.
Finish your race. That's my time, y'all. Thank you so much.
Finish. 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 The race is not given to the strong nor the swift. Saw an opportunity I had to take.
That was a bop right there. You on Spotify? I swear. What else we got? That was it. That was a bop. That was it right there. That was a whole bop, bro. So, you on Spotify? Izzy? Izzy on Spotify? We got Pastor Timothy Lemon here to share the word of God with y'all today.
Hallelujah. Look. My brother did it again. Look, last time he was here, he brought a word. He spoke into the atmosphere. My brother, you came and did it again. So I'm going to be honest with you, man. I don't feel like I got a little bit I'm going to add to that, man, but I'm not about to come behind it and feel like I got to preach a whole nother word, man. So look, I'm going to add to it. Look, the scripture for today is Jeremiah 29:11. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you a hope in the future. Young people, where you at? Young people, God has called you to a higher place. He has a plan for you. Listen, he has a plan for you. So whatever plan you done made for yourself, whatever plan that your friends or your other family members who are not in God, not in the will of God, have tried to label you with or put on you, God has the plan for you. So I encourage each and every one of you, get in the presence of God. How do you do that? Just talk to God. Talk to God, not like your mama, not like your daddy, not like Apostle, not like Lady T, not like me, like you want to talk to God. Tell God, talk to God like he is. Tell God, God is dope. Talk to him the way you talk to God and just allow God to just grow on the inside of you. Allow God to just show himself strong to you for who he is so you have an understanding for yourself, not through anybody else. Amen? And I got one last scripture I just want to add to that. I'm going to be done. I just want to add 1 Timothy 4:12-16. And I want every young person to get this in your spirit and just meditate. It's one of my favorite scriptures that I use through all of these years growing up, because I'm not that much older than a lot of y'all. But 1 Timothy 4:12-16, let no man despise thy youth, but be thou an example of the believers in word, in conversation, in charity, in spirit, in faith, and in purity. Look, when y'all young people at school, y'all can be an example to all believers. Y'all can go to school and represent Christ with your J's on, with your hat forward, hat backwards, whatever it is. Just go and represent Christ. Be an example of what God has called you to be. Every one of you guys have been taught from your parents, from the leaders in this house, how to walk and how to be an example. So I encourage all of you guys, be just that. Amen? Amen. Let me finish reading this. Thou an example of the believers in word and conversation and charity and spirit and faith and purity. Till I come, give attendance to reading, to exhortation, to doctrine. You guys read that word. Just start reading. Even if you just read one scripture a day, take one scripture, open up that Bible. Even if I seen somebody, I think Mother Johnson had one. Mama Johnson had like a comic book Bible. I thought it was good. It put some pictures on it. You know what I'm saying? So take the comic book Bible, because those Bibles still got the word. They still give you an understanding of what God is speaking. So take that, read that word for yourself. And if you got questions, come to your mom, your dad, the men and women of God in the house, and God will give you understanding. Like the Bible says, in all thy getting, get an understanding, and God will give it to you guys even at a young age. Amen. Neglect not the gift that is in thee, which was given thee by prophecy with the laying on of the hands of the presbytery. Meditate upon these things. Give thyself wholly to them, that thy profiting may appear to all. Take heed unto thyself and unto the doctrine. Continue in them. For in doing this, thou shalt be saved, both save thyself and them that hear thee. So take this scripture, y'all. Live and be an example to all of your friends at school, to all of the friends in the neighborhood. Rep Christ the way you rep Christ. Do God the way you do God. Take the word of God, apply it to your life. Be obedient to your parents. Be obedient to what the leaders are teaching you and just grow in God, amen? And look, Timothy, I read this verse from Timothy. I don't know if a lot of you guys know, but if you do the research, Timothy was a timid person. Timothy was not, Paul used Timothy and Titus. They were complete opposites. Timothy was timid. Timothy didn't feel like he was able to do a lot of the things that God had called him to do, yet he made a decision. So I encourage all of the young people, make a decision to just say, you know what, God, it's hard. God is real hard, but you know what? I'm going to do it anyway. I'm going to choose to walk in the things of God. I'm going to choose to stay faithful even though it's hard. And when I get weak, I'm going to take time to talk to my God about how I'm feeling and just be transparent like y'all talk to your friends. Just do that with God, amen? Amen, and watch God work in your life. Remember, let's go back to Jeremiah 29:11. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you. He wants to prosper you. God don't want you not prospering. He wants to give you everything that he has. Plans to prosper you, not to harm you, and plans to give you a hope and a future. So I declare and decree into every young person in here that you guys will be faithful. You guys will seek after God for yourself. You will be diligent. You will continue to go forward in the things of God. And like my brother here said, start and finish. Amen. Amen.
I just got asked to close out, so we're going to close out. I want to first pray before we close out, and then I'm going to do finish again one more time. Excuse me. Thank you. So, Father God, we just thank you for this moment. We thank you for this time, Lord. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for your spirit. Thank you for blessing us to see another day. Thank you for blessing us to see another year, another time. Thank you, Lord, for providing this opportunity for the youth to share their gift. Let them hear your word, Lord God, that you have bigger dreams. Let them be willing to put their dreams to the side and embrace the dreams that you have for them. I pray that you would give them a spirit of wisdom to know what you want them to do and how you want them to do it. I pray that you would give them a spirit of boldness. Give them clarity, Lord Jesus. I pray that you would surround your people, Lord God, with the right counsel, people that would speak the right words, people that would speak words of wisdom. We pray, Lord Jesus, that you would expose every enemy, every devil, every obstacle. We pray, Lord Jesus, in the name of Jesus, that you would give us your spirit. Let your spirit rise on the inside of us, Lord, that even when we face obstacles, we will stand on your word. We will stand on your promises. Just because we face obstacles doesn't mean that what you have spoken will not come to pass or cannot come to pass. It's just something that's an indication that what you have spoken shall come to pass. And so we just thank you, Lord Jesus, for bigger dreams. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen, amen. So I'm going to do finish one more time. Let me get the youth to come back up here again. Lady Johnson, she got the flag this time. Now bear with me a little bit. My throat is kind of, but we'll get back in it. We're going to finish this out, right? Yeah. Bigger dreams, y'all. Y'all remember that, right? Y'all remember that. Bigger dreams.